Well, the immigration discussion on Capitol Hill still continues, and the Secretary of Agriculture is weighing in as a March deadline to pass a funding bill is expected to trigger renewed immigration debate. RFD-TV's Sarah Mock has that story.
As producers begin the 2018 crop season, labor needs are mounting.
And agriculture greatly needs a legal workforce. And typically we would think that that would be a legal guest worker program. We know that we have H-2A, which is cumbersome.
Perdue supports a bill authored by Virginia Congressman Bob Goodlatte, which he says offers real wins for the ag and food industries.
Frankly, more enthusiastic about the original bill that Chairman Goodlatte had. In order to get it out of his committee, he had to bail some provisions that agriculture really appreciated. But nevertheless, we continue to support that statutorily, but we're not stopping there either.
Perdue says USDA is working with the Departments of Labor, State, and Homeland Security to modify H-2A regulations in order to make them more reasonable for workers who want to use the program. Perdue spoke particularly of states like California, where the Department of Justice recently filed a lawsuit over immigration issues.
At the end of the day, we are hopeful that some type of agricultural workforce, legal workforce, can be included in any kind of immigration debate that takes place. Californians have been very strong about the fact that it doesn't meet their needs, and we've heard them loudly and clearly, and we don't disagree with that, although we have got to start somewhere. And the fact that I don't know that they want to continue using an illegal workforce, which is currently occurring out there in many places today, which produces a lot of other ramifications.
But the bill's mechanism to cut down on illegal employment, the E-Verify system, raises questions of its own.
Our producers in agriculture are greatly concerned if we have an E-Verify system prior to having a legal guest worker program, they would be in a lot of trouble and be very, very painful for them.
Though the Goodlatte bill still doesn't have the votes to pass in the House, Perdue says he wouldn't expect any immigration reform bill to get the farm state votes it would need without a better H-2A provision. For RFD-TV, I'm Sarah Mock in Washington.
Well, the U.S. dairy industry is particularly interested in the outcome of a possible upcoming immigration debate, given that more than half of the cattle in the United States are milked by foreign-born workers. Well, stay with us. We've got our first check of the weather forecast with Christina Loren. That's coming up in just a moment.